We're going to write a balance equation for the given redox reaction in both acidic and basic conditions using these four simple steps. First step, we have to write out the half equations. And before we can do that, we need to first figure out which is an oxidation half equation and which is a reduction half equation. And to do that, we're going to use oxidation number. From the oxidation number, it looks like sulfur undergoes oxidation because its oxidation number increased from +4 to +6. Whereas Cl undergoes reduction because its oxidation number reduced from +1 to -1. Now we can write out our half equations. For oxidation, it's SO2 going to SO42-, whereas for reduction, it's OCl- going to Cl-. Next, step 2, we need to balance the atoms in this order. We start by balancing all atoms besides O and H, that means we need to balance S. Starting with our oxidation equation, it looks like S is already balanced because we have one S on the left hand side and one S on the right hand side. So that means it's already balanced. So we move on to balancing O. We use H2O to do that. On the left hand side, we have 2O. On the right hand side, we have 4O. That means we'll need to add 2H2O on the left hand side. Since we've added 2H2O, that means we now have 4H on the left hand side and no H on the right hand side. So to balance it, we're going to add 4H+ on the right hand side. Following the sequence when balancing the atoms makes it very easy and fast-free. Otherwise, it's going to take longer than is necessary. So now that we're done with the oxidation, let's move on to the reduction equation. We need to do the same thing for the reduction equation. Let's start with Cl. Looks like it's already balanced because both sides have 1 Cl. Next, we balance oxygen. On the left, we have 1 oxygen. On the right, we don't have any oxygen, so we're going to have to add 1 H2O on the right-hand side. Moving on to H, we don't have any H on the left, and we do have 2 H on the right, so that means we're going to add 2H+ on the left-hand side. With that, we're done with step 2. Moving on to step 3, we're going to have to balance the charge by adding electrons. From the oxidation equation that we've just balanced, the total charge on the left-hand side is 0 because both SO2 and H2O are neutral compounds, so they have no charge. On the right-hand side, we have -2 from SO42- and +4 from that 4H+. That gives us a total of +2 on the right-hand side. In order to balance the charge, we need to add 2 electrons on the right-hand side. That way, the total charge will become 0 and both sides now have the same charge. Let's do the same for the reduction equation. Left hand side, we have a total charge of +1 and -1 total charge for the right hand side. So to balance the charge, we need to add 2 electrons on the left and that gives us -1 on both sides. Now that we've balanced the charge on both sides, we need to make sure that the number of electrons in both oxidation and reduction equations are the same. For oxidation, we have 2 electrons. For reduction, we also have 2 electrons. Since they are both the same, we don't have to do anything to these equations. So we're good to go. Here's a tip to help us remember where to add the electrons. If it's oxidation equation, we need to add the electron on the right hand side. If it's reduction equation, we're going to have to add the electrons on the left hand side. If you find the electrons on the wrong side of the equation, that means something is wrong somewhere. Stop and check. Now let's add both equations up to give us the balanced equation in acidic condition. From oxidation, we have SO2 +2H2O. From reduction, we have OCl- +2H+ and 2 electrons. On the right hand side, we have SO42- +4H+ +2 electrons plus Cl- +H2O. Before we call it done, let's simplify the equation first. You notice that we have H2O on both sides of the equation. So we're going to cancel out that H2O and that will leave us with 1 H2O on the left hand side. We also have H+ appearing on both sides. So we're going to have to cancel them out and that will give us 2H+ on the right hand side. Same thing goes to the electrons. We have 2 electrons on both sides of the equation, so we cancel them out. Notice at this point, if you have different number of electrons, that means something went wrong somewhere. Most likely it's step 3, you forgot to multiply or you wrote down the wrong number of electrons. So make sure you stop and check your work. After we simplify, let's rewrite the equation. We get SO2 plus H2O plus OCl- giving us SO42- plus 2H+ and Cl-. That's our balance equation in acidic condition. To write the equation for basic condition, we'll need to add OH- on both sides of the equation for every H+ that we see. From our acidic condition, we balance it and we got 2H+ on the right hand side. So that means we're going to add 2 OH- on both sides of the equations like this. That 2 OH- minus that we added combined with that 2H+ on the right hand side is going to form 2H2O. Notice we have H2O appearing on both sides of the equation. We're now going to go ahead and simplify it, and that will end up with 1H2O on the right hand side. So we rewrite the equation and we get SO2 plus OCl minus plus 2OH minus, giving us SO4 2 minus plus H2O plus Cl minus. That is our balance equation in basic condition. To recap, we went through these four steps in balancing the redox equation in acidic and basic condition. When we add electrons in step 3, we need to make sure that we add it on the right hand side for oxidation and on the left hand side for reduction. And for acidic condition, when we balance the equation, we need to make sure that we have H plus appearing in the equation. And for basic condition, we need to make sure that we have OH minus in the equation and there should not be any H plus appearing in that final equation. And just to be super safe, we need to always double check our final work. We check to make sure that we have the same number of atoms and charges on both sides of the equation. I hope the four steps in balancing redox equation were helpful. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.